Something that I think about from time to time are those pollution maps when COVID lockdowns were happening. You know, we were emitting a lot less because we were driving less and we were eating out less and we were doing less stuff during lockdown. The reality is that the world can't be on lockdown all of the time. But if we're serious about decarbonizing the world, changing the way we separate chemical compounds is going to be a key to industrial decarbonization. The analogy I like to use is most industrial processing facilities today are like a pot of pasta. You boil off all the water to get to the pasta at the bottom of the pot instead of pouring it through a strainer in your sink, which at the industrial scale is 50% lower capital costs, 90% lower energy costs, and more modular and demand responsive. At Via Separations, we're chemical engineers, we're mechanical engineers, we're chemists, we're material scientist engineers, and we make that pasta strainer. We make that pasta strainer for a petroleum refinery, for a pulp mill, or for other manufacturing facilities. And we do that by playing with the materials and the chemistry. We play with the atoms that get us to a place where we can get the material to do what we need it to do for the customer. And then we put that into the system, the pumps, the pipes, the valves, and everything that integrates with the rest of the customer's facility. When I was a senior in undergrad as a mechanical engineer, I was taking a product design class that absolutely changed my life, 2009. I learned a lot about how teams work together and what the big levers for innovation were going to be. Fast forward a number of years, and I found myself working on my PhD in a material science lab, inventing new materials for filtration membranes. After my defense, before I had submitted my thesis, I learned about chemical separation. So my world into that point was all about water. It was all about water filtration and desalination. But there's this whole world of chemical separations. 10 times the volume of chemicals are boiled every year as water is filtered. And so I started learning about what could this mean for the manufacturing industry? What could this mean for industrial processing? And I spent the next 3 months with my co-founder and CTO, Brent Keller, talking to customers. And we started to understand that there was a need in the market for the product that we had invented. So what we have going on here is actually our very first pilot. We are testing it, operating it, training on it, because we're going to operate it at a facility for a couple of months, and then it's going to come back here before meeting its next customer. And the reason we do this is because we can do learning iterations. We can get better for every single customer. We can get bigger. We can get more product out of the flows through the system. And we have a couple of orders of magnitude left to go. But the cool thing is that by next year, we are going to be eliminating CO2 emissions from our customers' facilities. I think as a society, we're going to move from the old, inefficient, boiling way of doing things into a new, more energy efficient, more resource efficient filtration. That is how we at Via Separations are going to contribute to making this world a better place.